Welcome back, everyone, to this last episode. We're going to be finishing off the touch-ups on the model and completing the display stand. Got the last little bit of parts here. Got this here for the power, got the switch, display stand. Unfortunately, I have to add some more height on the bottom here because of the top bat fin. As you can see, it's gonna stick way up there, so I have to have like the display case like way up here kind of thing. So it's that's no big deal. That's easy fix. Now, first, I got the decals here for the wheels all ready to go. There we go. Looks good. And, of course, I need a larger display case. Ah, these bat fins. Ah. This is what I'm going to be using for the base right here. And this is the diagram I came up with. So it's going to be 13.5 inches long, 5 inches wide. And the plexiglass here I'm going to be using for the actual dome is going to be 5 inches tall. 5 inches wide, tall, and 13 and a half long. So this is what I'm going to start with right here. Got myself the ruler, a silver marker so I can see the lines on the black, and let's get this thing measured out. Just to make sure I got the right dimensions, I brought the car in and just measuring it up here. Now I left a fair amount of distance between the edges here, because I'm going to be grooving it down about a quarter of an inch all the way around, just to give the top display clear base something to lock into. So yeah, it looks like it's going to be just fine. Yep, good. Looks good. Now I'm going to try and cut it down the center of the line as best I can here. Make sure I got my hearing protectors and my safety goggles on. Alright, so I sanded the ends here smooth, rounded off the edges, looks good. Now I just got to put the quarter inch groove in all the way around, and that will complete this part, well, for the most part. Then I got to cut grooves in the bottom here for the switch and for the power source. Once I find out where the wires are going to go from the rear wheels, probably down on this side here, because this is the side here that's got that coating on it. So probably like the hole come down here, power source out the side, and switch out the front, so it'll be like grooved in here like an L. So I got the blade down now to about a quarter of an inch, and it's just to start cutting. We'll be right back. Looks good all the way around. Okay, as you can see here, everything looks good. Dimensions. Lots of room. Okay, now time to get this done. All right, I got the two long sides here done. I just got to cut them out now. Okay, got the sides there, the sides are done, looks good, all right. Okay, now I'm gonna do the top part. And that's the final piece. And then after that, all the edges here will be cut on a 45 degree angle. Three edges on the sides here and three edges on the sides here will be cut on a 45 degree angle as well. Okay, moving it over to 45. Lock it in. There we go, that's everything done now. The base, the top, the two small ends, the two large sides that go on the sides here. Just got to glue it all together and it's finished. I'll be using this LePage heavy duty contact glue. It has the brush on the end of the cap here. It makes it easier for me to glue all the clear pieces together. This is where I'm going to be drilling the hole for the wiring here to go from the bottom of the Batmobile down through the stand. Okay, it's coming along real good. Give it a good 24 hours to dry. And yeah, it's going to be real nice. Just got to let that dry now. And then I got corner pieces that I'll be putting on as well. Just makes it look a little bit better. Here's what I got here, these little corner piece here that will go on the edges all the way around. There we go, got that all done. Don't really need to worry about this because I'm going to be painting this over with a flat black, sort of like simulate the asphalt. But I'm going to be putting in a couple of lines, you know, like the lines you see down the center of the road, the highway, and that, like maybe along the edge here or something like that. Just like they're on a highway. Okay, so I just got to figure out where I want the switch. So the Batmobile will be facing front here. So I put the switch like here. And the power supply on the back there. So I would cut up to a point here, but not all the way to the end. And then I'll just drill a hole for the wiring from the switch. And then from here, sort of cut there and then drill a hole this way for the power supply. And then fill it in with wood filler afterwards, smoothing it down and paint it, and then you won't even know it was there.
All right, there we go. Got that all done. So just got to put a hole on this end and there for the wiring, and this is ready to go for the wiring. Okay, I got the switch here, but I have to make the opening here be able to slide this here inside the so I have to have this body cavity a little bit larger to fit the guts of the switch up tight. There we go. It's in there. A little bit crooked, but that doesn't really matter. And then I just got a couple of tiny little screws. I can put one there and one there, and that's it for that. And now it's just a matter of running the wires, and after that, wood fill it in, let it dry, paint it, and the stand is officially finished. There we go. Now it's just, that's what it's gonna look like when it's all wired up. Of course, I gotta take it all off to put the wires on, but then it's ready to go.
All right, I primed the stand to get it ready for the flat black, and then I can start doing the wiring.
There we go, looks good. All right, so now we're ready for the wiring here. So I'm gonna put this in first. This goes in here.
Probably stick out a little bit like this. All right, first things last. Add on some heat shrink. Just so there's enough give here for the battery. Let me see here. Now, wire up the switch. Didn't need that terminal, just these two. I got the two positive lines go to the terminals here.
Good. this positive. So this positive line here, coming from the switch, goes to the positive here that provides the power to the plug. And then this positive goes to the model, which will come out this hole here. And then the negative from the model will go to this negative wire down here. Alright, so let's get the model in place here. Go.
Moment of truth. Quick lighting test. Looking good. Oh ho ho ho! Looking good. We are clear. Not bad. Not bad at all. There we go. This baby's done. Very good. Nice. Turned out really well. So if you all enjoyed it, please like, subscribe, and comment. And if you have any questions or you want me to do some commission work for you, contact me at modelbuilder501@yahoo.ca. Stay tuned for further builds and enjoy. Catch you guys later. Bye-bye. We'll be right back.